In most introductory econ courses, the concept of diminishing marginal utility is taught in a way that makes it about the pleasure or the good feeling we get from consuming goods. The usual story is that if we say eat multiple pieces of cake, we will eventually get less and less pleasure from each additional piece. The second piece won't taste as good as the first, the third won't taste as good as the second, and so on. For Austrian economists, the idea of diminishing marginal utility is that humans always try to allocate the means at their disposal to the most highly valued end they have first, then the next most valued one, and so forth. For Austrians, it's not about feeling good, but ensuring that our most valued ends are satisfied, whatever the reasons might be for us having those particular ends. Utility is not about a feeling, but about the usefulness of particular goods for satisfying our wants. Water has utility because it can be used for a variety of purposes, to quench our thirst, to water our crops, to bathe ourselves, and so on. Specific amounts of water have value because they can satisfy those specific wants. We perceive water to be an effective means toward an end. To see how this ties to diminishing marginal utility, imagine we have someone stranded on a deserted island with only 3 buckets of water available to her. And imagine that she has the following scale of wants in order of their importance to her. First, and most important, quench her thirst. Second, water her crops. Third, bathe. Fourth, clean her clothes. If each of those wants can be satisfied with one and only one bucket of water, she'll allocate the first bucket to quenching her thirst, her most important want, the second to watering her crops, and the third to bathing. Her wants of having clean clothes will go unfulfilled if she only has 3 buckets. In this context, the marginal utility of water for Austrians refers to the specific ability of a specific unit of water, in this case a bucket, to fulfill a want of particular intensity. The marginal utility of the first bucket of water corresponds to the subjective value she places on quenching her thirst. The marginal utility of the second bucket corresponds to the value she places on watering her crops. And marginal utility in general refers to the last and therefore the least valued want we can satisfy with the good in question. In this case, the value she attaches to bathing. The value of a means, specific buckets of water, is derived from the value we place on the ends that they can satisfy. Notice, too, that marginal utility always diminishes because we satisfy the most valued ends first. It's not about happiness, it's not about feeling good, but it's about the satisfaction of valued ends, no matter how they make us feel. For Austrians, diminishing marginal utility is a feature of the fact that we try to allocate resources to satisfy our most valued ends first. 2 other things to notice here. We can show the idea of opportunity cost, and we can link marginal utility to price. By choosing to allocate the last bucket to bathing, our friend is choosing not to wash her clothes. The opportunity cost of her choice to bathe is giving up clean clothes. When we make choices, we're really deciding between the value of the 2 wants we might satisfy. Opportunity cost is always about utility, about our subjective assessment of the importance to us of the alternative ends we could satisfy. You can also see how this ties to price. What our friend would be willing to pay for a 4th bucket of water will be related to the marginal utility of that bucket, which in turn reflects the specific subjective value she places on satisfying the want of having clean clothes. You can also see why, when the price of a good falls, people buy more of it. At a lower price, we are more willing to try to satisfy lower rank wants because we don't have to give up as much money to purchase the means to satisfy that want. If our friend on the island had to buy those buckets of water, you can see that at a sufficiently high price, it would not be worth it to buy a 3rd or perhaps even a 2nd bucket of water. More precisely, at a sufficiently high price, she would rather use her money to buy some other good to satisfy some other more highly valued want. An exercise for you to think about. Can you see why it would take a higher price to get her to supply, that is to give up, 2 buckets of water rather than just 1? For Austrian economists, utility is about the usefulness of a means for satisfying a want, and marginal utility is about the usefulness of a specific quantity of a good for satisfying a specific want. It's not about happiness, it's not about pleasure. And because we try to satisfy our most important wants first, the marginal utility of successive units of a good will always decline. The successive unit is applied to a less and less valued end. This insight is crucial for understanding why demand and supply curves slope the way they do, and the role that those curves play in determining market prices, and how all of this links back to human perceptions and human choices.